We are from Dr. Banuben Mahendra Nanavati College of Home Science, which is affiliated to SNDT Women's University, Mumbai. Also, UGC status of our college is College with Potential for Excellence. Recently, our college was awarded as Best College, adjudged by SNDT Women's University.
Hello everyone!
So we are students of Dr. BMN College of Home Science from Department of Food Science and Nutrition. I am Palvi Bhosle.
I am Priyanka Sharma.
I am Prunal Chavan.
I am Ayushi Gala.
I am Purva Vilas Bhadwar.
And today we are here to give you a brief information about adolescent nutrition.
Introduction. Adolescence describes the age between 13 to 19, but we are mainly concentrating on age 15 to 19. Adolescence means transform from childhood to adulthood. Physical changes, hormonal changes, and significant weight gain. Adolescent boys tend to gain more weight and skeletal growth continues for a long time. Girls have more of body fat and more of adipose tissue as compared to males. Females, as lean body mass has more active metabolic function than adipose tissue. Sex difference also contributes to difference in nutritional requirement.
Now we will see the RDA for adolescent stage. Now we will see the wrong eating habits in adolescent stage.
Junk food. Junk food is a term for cheap food containing high levels of calories from sugar or fat with little fiber, protein, vitamins and minerals. Nowadays, junk food consumption have been increased drastically in adolescent because it attracts very easily, reasonable, instant, also has a very good taste, but junk food has no nutritional value in it. It also attracts due to trend and peer pressure. Junk food has a high level of sodium content and also high level of sugar, which leads to hyperactivity.
Eating huge portions. Long run spikes your hunger, but your body cannot process a huge dose of calories, even when your glucose stores are spent. When you eat too much at one time, you risk storing it as fat.
Skipping meal. Every meal is believed to be important meal, but many people still seem a habit out of skipping it. Doing so, it not only drains you of energy, but also makes it more likely that you will snack throughout the day. Skipping meal also disturbs your metabolism, causing you to burn fewer calories. Having occasionally late night snacks is fine, but if you cannot go to bed without having something, then you would be setting yourself up for weight gain. Eating too close to bedtime will also give you sleeping difficulty, since your body will be busy digesting food. You run in the morning but don't eat much all day because you are dealing with life, and then you binge at dinner and beyond.
Mindless eating. Instead of just eating when hungry, many of us grab food when we are bored, tired, happy or sad. If you eat while watching TV, while reading or even while cooking, then you are also developing an unhealthy eating habit. When you eat while doing other activities, you become unable to measure how much you eat. As a result, tends to overeat without knowing it.
These are some eating disorders in adolescent stage.
Eating disorder, anorexia nervosa. Increasing rate of anorexia in adolescents is sometimes seen as a consequence of excessive dieting in overweight adolescents. Anorexia adolescents sometimes describe themselves as obese, but most of such individuals have only pursued themselves as obese. There is some risk that non-obese adolescents who are psychologically under the impression that they are obese may develop anorexia by seeing publicity promoting slimming diet and lean physique. The onset of anorexia is usually in adolescents, although cases of prepubertal and adult onset have been reported. The disorder typically starts with an episode of dieting, although the path into this behavior can vary. For some natural bodily changes that accompany puberty or a negative weight-related or shape-related comment from another person may lead to a conscious decision to diet. For others, an episode of physical illness with associated weight loss, such as glandular fever, may lead to more intentional dietary restriction. Commonly occurring low self-worth, positive feedback in the form of attention from others initially serves to reinforce dieting behavior and further weight loss. Patients with anorexia also report a sense of euphoria at being in control of their weight. Assessment. A large portion of people with anorexia are ambivalent about seeking treatment, and many will have been pursued to seek help by concerned relatives or friends. Thus, assessment forms a crucial part of the treatment process. Assessment should cover psychological, social, and physical needs, as well as assessment of risk to self and others. Where possible, the diagnosis should be made using a standardized diagnostic instrument such as structured clinical interview for diagnostic and statistical manual and severe combined immunodeficiency. Physical tests are as such not required to diagnose anorexia.
EDNOS. A proportion present with all key features of bulimia nervosa but fail to fulfill the diagnostic criteria relating to frequency occurrence of behavioral symptoms. The key characteristics of EDNOS patients include eating much more rapidly than normal, eating until feeling uncomfortably full, and large amount of food when not feeling physically hungry, and feeling disgust with oneself after overeating. This disorder is commonly associated with obesity. Modified versions of standard treatment for bulimia nervosa has been developed for use with those patients. However, no clinical trials has been conducted on those patients with EDNOS.
Laxatives. Teenagers use laxatives for weight loss, but laxative as such doesn't help you to lose fat. Instead, it will start to lose your water weight. Laxatives may lead to constipation, and if it is used for long term, it could be highly dangerous to your health. That is, it can drop your blood pressure and even cause permanent kidney damage.
Steroid. A steroid is an organic compound with four rings arranged in a specific molecular configuration. Effects of steroid on human body. Problems in the hormonal system in men, infertility, breast development, shrinking of the testicles. In women, enlargement of clitoris, excessive growth of body hair, male pattern, baldness. In musculoskeletal system, short stature, if taken by adolescents, tendon ruptures. In cardiovascular system, increase in the level of LDL, decrease in HDL, high blood pressure, heart attacks, enlargement of heart's left ventricle. In liver, cancer, and in skin, severe acne and cyst, oily scalp, jaundice, fluid retention.
PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome, is a condition in which a woman's level of sex hormones, estrogen and progesterone, are out of balance. This leads to growth of ovarian cyst. PCOS can affect a woman's menstrual cycle, fertility, cardiac function and appearance. Symptoms: excess hair on the face, chest, stomach, thumbs or toes, decrease in breast size, deeper voice, hair loss. Other symptoms may include acne, weight gain,
pelvic gain, depression, infertility. Treatment of PCOS. Eat a healthy diet. Take birth control pills. If you aren't planning to become pregnant, ask your doctor for medications that may help you. Diagnosis of PCOS has no definite test, but there is thyroid function test, fasting glucose test, lipid level test.
Bulimia. The first is recurrent episode of binge eating during which an objectively large amount of food is consumed with associated loss of perceived control of eating. The second feature is the use of compensatory behaviors designed to prevent weight gain. This includes dietary restriction, self-induced vomiting, misuse of laxatives or diuretics, and excessive exercise. The third feature is the same set of attitudes and values seen in anorexia nervosa, with
worth being determined almost exclusively on the basis of weight, shape, and ability to control food intake. Clinical feature: people who are suffering from bulimia tend to judge their self-worth almost excessively on the basis and weight and shape and the ability to control their food intake. They also use extreme forms of weight control such as fasting and self-induced vomiting, but people who lie in the same range and they have binge eating habit and it usually consists of more than 2000 kilocalorie and tend to consist food person is avoiding. Patient is always stuck in the fear of weight gain due to their binge eating habit. They steal money and food. They binge in secret and purge in secret. People with bulimia have emotional regulations and they become intolerable. They also have interpersonal difficulty and impulse control problem. Physical health. Complications include irregular absent menstruation in girls, weakness and lethargy, abdominal pain and toothache. There is enlargement of parotid gland, electrolyte distribution is uneven, those who vomit frequently. Treatment. Electrolyte disturbance must be solved with the help of potassium supplement until the eating disorder has been solved.
Assessment. Many patients with bulimia feel too guilty and ashamed of their illness and often lie with their disorders for years before seeking treatment. No physical tests are needed to establish the diagnosis. However, the electrolytes should be checked of all those who vomit frequently or misuse large quantities of laxatives or diuretics.
Here is a meal plan for adolescent girl and boy. It follows 5 meal pattern. For early morning, we have suggested ragi uttappa for girl and milk with nuts and jaggery for boy. One can make it interesting by adding different flavors and veggies. For breakfast, cornflakes for girls and veggie paratha for boy. One can make paratha with multigrain atta or flour of your choice. For lunch, we have suggested any kind of bhakri or chapati, leafy vegetable bhaji with groundnut, rice and dal, salad for girl. And one can substitute veggie bhaji with fish or chicken curry. For boy, any kind of bhakri and methi matar malai bhaji and curd rice. For non-veg option, one can substitute bhaji with malai chicken curry. For snacks, cheese pizza on brown bread. For non-veg option, one can make pizza with chicken. And fruit salad, in which one fruit should be citrus, one should be any fruit of your choice for girl. And for boy, cheese veggie frankie. For non-vegetarian people, veggies can be changed into chicken or fish. And fruit salad, in which two fruits should be of your choice and one fruit should be citrus fruit. For dinner, it's similar for both, dal khichdi with raita. To make meal interesting, meal should have color and different textures and one meal should be of their choice. It's okay to have junk food which is made at home. Any meal can be substituted by different cuisines to make it more attractive. Thank you for watching our video. For more details and information and various tips, visit our blog. The link is mentioned down below in description box. Thank you.